Good morning everyone and welcome to your maths lesson. Let's go through the date together. Yesterday was Tuesday, so today is Wednesday. Yesterday was the 2nd, so today is the 3rd. Today is Wednesday the 3rd of February. Have a look at the calendar on my screen. Can you point to where you think today is? Mochi's going to show us. There we are, Wednesday the 3rd. Let's sing our Days of the Week song together that we've been learning. Just to remind you, it goes like this. Days of the week, days of the week. 5 days at school, 2 for weekend, days of the week. There's Monday and there's Tuesday, there's Wednesday and there's Thursday, there's Friday and then Saturday, and finally then Sunday. And then we repeat. Join in as best you can. We have been learning some new maths. We have been exploring doubling. And Mochi has been helping us by telling us a story of the doubling dog. Well, now his story takes a bit of a turn and we read the next part. Drum roll, please. This is the story of two halves. Now, Mochi had loved his time with his magic mirror. It had helped him to double almost anything he put in front of it. But the fairy came to take it back and it was time to say goodbye to the magic mirror. "I hope you've enjoyed it, Mochi," said the fairy. "What have you learnt?" Now we're going to pause. I would like you to tell me what you've learnt about doubling. "Well," said Mochi, "doubling is when you have the same number again. So if I had 2 and I doubled it, I would need another 2. Double 2 is 4. "Wow," said the fairy, "that's fantastic learning. But it's time to take the mirror away." "Oh, do you have to take it away?" said Mochi. "Tell you what," said the fairy, "as you've been doing such great learning, I am going to give you this beautiful cake." "Oh," said Mochi, "that looks delicious." "But there's one condition," said the fairy. "You have to share that with your brother." "What?" said Mochi. "Do I have to?" "Yes. And you can only have it if you can tell me what a half is." "I don't know what a half is," said Mochi. He was very puzzled. "Well, if you can tell me in 2 days' time what halving is, then you get to have your cake." "Got to go now. Bye." Can we say goodbye to the fairy? Off she goes. Bye. Smelling that delicious cake from afar came Soji. This is Mochi's brother. Soji said, "Hey, Mochi, whose is that cake for?" "Well," said Mochi, "that's for us to share. But I have to tell the fairy what a half is. Do you know what halving is?" "No, I don't." "Right, okay," so Mochi put his thinking cap on. "Who can help me with halving?" "I know. My friends helped me with doubling yesterday. Why don't I go and pay them a visit and see if they can help me with halving?" "Great idea," said Soji. So Mochi got his lead on and off he went into the woodlands. Ooh, now when he got there, the first person he bumped into was the squirrel. "Squirrel," said Mochi, "do you know what halving means?" "Yes," said the squirrel. That's when you split your number into two equal groups. Two groups, said Mochi. I think I can do that. Why don't we practice with my acorns, said the squirrel. How many do you have, said Mochi. Let's count them together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if I need to put these 6 acorns into two groups, why don't I have one and you have the rest? No, said the squirrel. That wouldn't be fair. Okay, said Mochi. I have 6, so what about if I have 2 and then you have 4? No, said the squirrel. The groups have to be the same. Well, how do I do that? Said Mochi. I'll show you. It goes like this, said the squirrel. 1 for you and 1 for me. 1 for you and 1 for me. Can you join in with me now? 1 for you and 1 for me. We've split them into two groups. How many does Mochi have? 3. Great. How many does the squirrel have? 3. Fantastic. So I have learnt that half of 6 equals 3. Mochi has 3 and the squirrels have 3. So let's say our sentence together. Half of 6 equals 3. Okay, I think I'm getting it, said Mochi. I wonder who else I can practice with. So off he set and he bumped into... It's Bumble, the bumblebee. Hey Bumble, said Mochi. I'm learning about halving. Can you help me? Of course, said the bumblebee. Now remember, halving is when you split your number into two groups. Got it, said Mochi. So, let's count my flowers. Count with me now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There were 8 flowers. How about I have one flower and you have the rest? No, said the bumblebee. The groups have to be equal. Oh yeah, said Mochi. How do I do that again? Like this, said the bumblebee. 1 for you, 1 for me. 1 for you, 1 for me. Can you join in now? 1 for you, 1 for me. 1 for you, 1 for me. Right, how many does Mochi have? 4, well done. How many does the bumblebee have? 4 as well. So they both have the same. So I have learnt that half of 8 equals 4. Can we say that together? Half of 8 is 4. Well done. Right, I've got the hang of it now, said Mochi. And he went to find his friend Freddy the bird. There he is. Hi, Freddy, said Mochi. I've been learning about halving. Oh, I love halving, said Freddy. It's when we get to share. That's right, said Mochi. Can we share your sticks? Sure, said Freddy. Let's count how many he has. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. Okay. Now Mochi said, Freddy, I think I'm right here, but when we have to have two groups. And these two groups have to have the same number in them. That's right, said Freddy the bird. Let's share our sticks out. Can you say it with me, everyone? One for you, one for me. 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 Great. How many sticks does Mochi have? Five. Great. How many sticks does Freddy have? Five as well. Fantastic. So we have learned that half of 10 equals 5. Let's say that together. Half of 10 equals 5. Great learning. Now, this is your challenge. We are going to find some objects that we can share. So if you're at home, these are some things that you might want to share. Toys. You might want to share sweets, maybe cups or forks. Or maybe you have some teddies that you'd like to share. And what your challenge now is to half these amounts. So you're going to get 10 toys. And then you're going to halve them. You're going to share them with someone. It might be somebody that you live with. It might be your little sister or your little brother. It might be your mum or dad. And you're going to go one for me, one for you. One for me, one for you. Until they're all gone. And then you're going to count how many you have. And we're going to see if we can say the sentence. Half of 10 equals 5. So you've got to say your sentence today. If you're at school, you might want to use the cubes and work with a partner to share them. One for you, one for me, one for you, one for me. Now, if you need an extra challenge today, you can write me a message on Discord, because I would like to know how I would share this cake. Good luck with your challenge, everybody, and I'll see you tomorrow for the next part of the story. Bye!